one of the holy angels who was with me and who conducted me answered.
I'm a holy rat. Just put it out there, okay? White Stag Education. Let's get educated by a stag. A white one, to be specific. Anyway. Hein Baron's hiking safety. Alright. Safety tips on hiking. Rated by Dan. Saying Dan. Going on, bruh. Collaboration with Ocean County Parks and Recreation. Hiking in the New Jersey Pine Barrens can be a wonderful experience, but it's not without its dangers. Is there dangers in every place, isn't there? Especially hiking places. Okay, we got some safety methods coming. Woohoo! Hope I don't die while watching this. Find out. I'm excited. I want to learn how to hike safely. Okay, so stick to the trails. Okay. I mean, I might go for a detour, but, you know. Well, I guess we'll find out. It's important to stay on the right path. I mean, what if I want to get lost, though? Like, just in general. Okay. Well, I'm the kind of person that would probably get lost by following them anyway, but there we are. Just put it out there. Okay. A single rectangle means that we need to continue straight. Alright. Pretty simple. A left turn for two rectangles. Okay, and these are red. Alright. Okay, and then the right turn is when they form a right diagonal. Alright. Sounds pretty simple. As of 1968, it's mandated that all trails must be blazed. What? Really? Oh, I bet there is suspicious markers. The government are probably effing you over, isn't it? You will not return. Yeah. Probably. Probably some extra entity that's going to eff you over, right? Is that a white stag? By any chance? I'm guessing here. I don't know. Probably not. Okay, acquire equipment. Alright. Give me it. My question is though, can Dan get me this equipment? Do I have to do it myself? Because I'm a lazy fucker. So to be honest, Dan, just get me the stuff, please. Yes, thank you. Any obstacle you may face? I mean, yeah. Poisonous plants? Whatever. Okay, we've got a checklist coming. I'm excited. Show me. We got... Got food, water, hiking boots, weather, appropriate clothing, first aid kit, a compass, a knife, and a flashlight. Okay. Don't put the flashlight anywhere you don't want it to be, guys, okay? Not up your bum, alright? Just burning. Be good with it. Compass is good, but then what about if it's cursed? Like on the Pirates of the Caribbean. Is it a Santa? I don't know if I trust the people in it, to be honest. Surprise me if they're in it all together. Not make us return. No. Near the forest. Why should I be scared of it? I should be okay to be in there, right? Why should I fear it? Isn't right, is it, really? So there's masked people in there. Oh, God. An unholy entity holds dominion over the woods. Their observations augment its strength. Oh, God, are we going to see them? What? Oh God, he stumbled against... Whoa, hello, who the... What the frick? Oh, they're creepy, bro. I don't like that. Evacuate. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be returning anytime soon then. Mass people have got me. It seems. Whoa! Alright, dude. Blood out loud. Woo! It's only some masked people. Calm down. Honestly, it's okay. It's really not. Whoa! Alright, dude. Alright, dude. Oh, I ain't going there. You're welcome, but I don't really think I wanted to. Stay safe out there. Ah. Honestly, I'm going to tell you now, I don't feel safe at all after watching that video. And it actually makes me... Probably a little bit late for the party, because we're now at a Christmas Eve candlelight service, but I guess we can go back in time, all right? I guess. See. Is this like part of like their little cult thing? I don't know. You know what? I've not been to a church in years. Hey, Grandwood Church of the Pines. So is this church like near the forest then or what? I'm going to assume so. Pastor George Robertson. Can I say that he's evil right now and he's probably the one that's like the cult leader of... Ask people. Got Dan in there as well. Why does that statue look so creepy? It's so creepy. Special thanks to these people. I'm also going to say thank you to the statue too. Thank you, statue, for all your time standing there and just looking at me look very weirdly. Thank you. I don't know. I'll try and make it a bit comedic, right?
Somehow. Christmas. Christmas is a time for people to come together.
Right.
Friends, families, enemies, warring nations.
Yep.
To celebrate the great gift God has given us this day.
Yep.
His son, Jesus Christ.
Hmm?
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Right, I know this is going to sound really weird, right? But if you look at the part, when you were just listening to that, I saw, like, the leaf moving, or one of the leaves moving near the, like, the thing, the statue thing. And I literally thought their hand was moving, but it's not. I'm so sorry. It just came to my mind and I had to tell you guys. I'm really sorry. I had to say it. I'm sorry.
Our Lord has given us creation and the opportunity to do with it as we wish.
All right, yeah.
We have the choice to sin or to be faithful.
These statues are freaking me out, man, like an absolute mofo. And I'm honestly going to say this now. I don't think I'll be very faithful to you. As in the statue, because that statue is very creepy. I think I'm going to sin it.
Our Lord has given us his son to undo even Adam's original sin.
All right.
Jesus showed us that even with free will, we can live a life free of sin.
Can we, though? Questionable, really, isn't it, to be honest?
21:4. There, too, I beheld seven stars of heaven bound in it together, like great mountains and like a blazing fire.
It's a bit hot in here, isn't it?
For what species of crime have they been bound, and why have they been removed to this place? Then, Uriel, one of the holy angels who was with me and who conducted me, answered.
I'm a holy rat. Just put it out there, okay?
Wherefore dost thou ask? Wherefore reason with thyself and anxiously inquire? These are those of the stars which have transgressed the commandment of the Most High God.
That's me.
Who? And are here bound until the infinite number of the days of their crimes be completed.
I've never done any crimes in my life. Lens, a camcorder will only record audio until we start.
Thank you so much.
What?
Be quiet.
Dan. Okay. Basement door just opened, isn't it? I really want to know what's going on. Visually.
Holy shit!
Be whoa.
Quiet. This will only take a second.
Right, so just to clarify, in case you guys can't see these subtitles, which I think you can, but just to confirm. So, Luke and Dan, so they are the people that were in this, obviously in this video at the start. They've just gone down to a basement, and an animal, or an unknown sound of an animal, has gone... Meow. He's gone, be quiet. Blah, blah, blah. Is he going to shoot it? Whoa, okay. Right. Oh no, the unknown animal's crying. And it's chained up.
Shit! Fuck! Jesus Christ!
Whoa!
Fuck!
What is the animal?
Fuck.
Whoa!
Holy shit!
So sorry, but I need to get involved in this. Sorry. What is the unknown animal? This is not fair. I think, is it a stag? Is it? I don't know. It's something though. I love how it's like soothing sound as soon as like an animal's being effed. Really? These statues creep me out even more. Oh, bruh. Honestly. The hell. Oh. Well, there we go. So, based on the two videos so far, we've had hiking sort of help get away from the forest. And now we've got Luke and Dan. And they've just left over an animal that was chained up. And now it's, I guess, escaped because they're running, maybe? I don't know. But the following video was not produced by White Stag. We've redistributed this video for educational purposes only. The use of a domestic pill, similar products, is highly discouraged. Health warning. Fine. Okay. Can I try it, though? Can I try it, please? Okay, so Genesis Technologies have been developing a drug that heightens the accuracy of human foresight. Okay. Okay, it looks like your standard drug you find. Okay. Cool. Oh, okay. So they've been doing tests and trials. Okay, what side effects are we talking, though? Anxiety? Turn into a mass person? Test one, a mouse and a pitfall maze. Okay. You were testing on my family! What? I know I'm a rat and, like, mice are in my sort of rodent family. I can't believe they tested on them. Wow, I'm actually ashamed. I am absolutely such ashamed! We're given 50 milligrams dose. Quite a lot, to be fair, actually. Who goes to 25 of them? 50 of them there. Nice. Okay, so in the first group, zero 25. Didn't even get there. Oh shit. Oh no. Poor ratties or poor mices. Okay, so in the second group, 19 actually reached the cheese at the other end, making it 76% success rate. Well, GG's to the 19 of the other 25 then. But I guess basically one lot of the mice were pretty like dumb and the other lot were okay. Yes. Hello. Yes, sir. Actually, no, I'm being stupid. Basically, they weren't done. Basically, one of them wasn't drugged and the other one was. So basically, it seems like, on that basis then, that if you're not drugged by this drug, then you can get through it. And you fall into the pitfall, but if you are taking this drug, then you're able to basically reach the end and follow it through. But then again, you're just going against your natural instinct. So, I just want to know what it's going to be used for, though. Like, what is it used for, like? My question. You don't agree with animal testing, like the video. There you go. Especially my rodent family as well. Very unfair. Okay, so we've now got test two. So it's basically us and a stoplight. Okay, so two groups of 25 test subjects were sat in the front of a stoplight. Group one acted as the control group, while group two were given 200 milligrams dose. Quite a bit of that, actually. Do with accuracy. Oh god, I'd be terrible at this. You might as well give me the drug. It works. Oh wow. So group one made 79 correct guesses. 31% correct rate. Okay. They weren't taking the drug then. Alright. Oh my god, so with group two that actually took the drug, they got 100% correct rate. Yeah. The drug definitely changes us then, right? Basically makes us robotic, if I'm honest. It seems like, really. Weird. That's crazy. I'm still questioning what this drug's being used for, though. Like, what's it doing? Is it, like, making it save you from something, or what? The only thing that I'm kind of getting from this, which I don't know if I'm just jumping the gun, but as if you remember in the first video when they spoke about you going in the forest and then you have to follow the path, and if you follow the path right, then you're okay. But if you don't, and you're never coming back. So I don't know if this kind of links that this drug is given to people. Maybe that some are going through the forest, and the people that don't take the drug get lost and don't come back, but the people that take the drug are able to get through the forest. I don't know if I'm just jumping the gun. That is kind of like how I kind of am looking at it. I don't know. I don't know. It just seems a bit, I don't know, maybe. If I'm wrong, then let me know, but I'm getting that gist at this point. Right, the big part, potential side effects. Okay. Having more vivid and lifelike dreams while asleep. These dreams can cause paranoia and insomnia. I have insomnia all the time, lovely. Oh, so we're going to see two dreams, I think, that are caused by the stimulation of the subconscious mind and may possibly depict future events. Yeah. Margaret Pendleton's dream was about a never-before-televised puppet showing features for colourful puppets and a park ranger. She said the puppet illustrated was named Rex. Runs with a dinosaur, but yeah. Felt like she had seen the program 100 times before, despite it never existing. That's weird. What do you think? Got Henry Ledger now, this is his dream. Like some kind of meteor, yeah. He watched the meteor crash near his home in Barngat Township, New Jersey. Thank you. Oh shit, that's crazy. So his dream basically helped this company. Let's go for a new comment. Whoa, okay, that was a little bit weird. What about? Oh. Now we've got Daniel Carpenter's dream, and that's the masked people in the forest, right? No way. Nah. In Daniel's dream, he was standing in front of a group of masked humanoids. Oh. He recalled an immense amount of heat, the large hole they surrounded. So, Daniel transcripted this melody, which he heard in his dream. So, bear with me. So, was that footage we saw earlier, was that a dream all along? Maybe? I don't know. Oh, the 3 days after his dream, he had a violent encounter with three of the masks from his dream. However, he did not come across a large hole in the ground. Right. What? God, I don't know. Thank you for watching it. No, I'm not, thank you. I don't really think I want to take that drug, and you guys stay away from it. Haha. Odd. Weird. So that's White Stag Education. Very, very cool series. Definitely got some kind of story to it. If I'm brutally honest, I'm a little bit out of my league a bit, as in, like, I'm kind of think I know what's going on, but I'm not 100% sure. Maybe it's something I need to relook at. I definitely would like to go back to this, though. Go and check out the creator in my description. If you enjoyed my reaction also, consider liking and subscribing to my channel. And, yeah, I think it was good. It was all right. Not too bad. I'm a little bit confused, but I guess more videos will find out a bit more. But it was good. So, yeah, thank you for watching. And peace out. Keep it locked. And leave me alone.